I got the key to the highway. Built out and I'm bound to go.
We're traveling down Highway 90, the road most traveled, the strip of blacktop that knits together the music and culture from Houston to Jacksonville. I'm Kip Lornell of George Washington University, and this time we're stopping in Clarksdale, Mississippi, the home of the Delta Blues.
Now give me one more kiss, baby. Yeah, before I go.
The blues is the most important form of American music developed in the 20th century. I know that sounds dramatic, but I really believe it's true. Without blues, you would not have had rock and roll, you would have not have had rhythm and blues, you would not have had hip-hop, and you would not have had rap. The whole idea of talking about troubles in the black community comes from both gospel music, but also from the blues, and we're listening right now to Muddy Waters, who's one of the premier bluesmen of the 20th century.
Not so long.
Muddy Waters is important because not only is a Chicago bluesman who pioneered a new form of electrified music that came into Chicago after World War II, he grew up in Clarksdale, Mississippi on a plantation, and a lot of the music he listened to is directly related to the old Delta blues singers who played on acoustic guitars and played at juke joints in the 1920s and 30s. One of the people that Muddy Waters listened to, both in person and certainly on phonograph records, was a man named Robert Johnson, who has gained legendary status in the 1980s and 1990s as one of the progenitors of the Delta Blues.
That's been the black man you've been loving. Good friend can get my room.
Back in the Mississippi Delta, the blues has largely been supplanted by other forms of black popular music. But there's still a few bluesmen who are playing the old-style country blues and the newer-style juke joint blues. One of those people is Super Chikan.
Hardship is where the blues come from. Slavery is where the blues come from. So that's what drove people to the blues. Nobody could get any relief from hard labor. If you want to really know where the blues come from, that's where it came from.
Now here at the crossroads, everybody's under the spell. All we do down here is give each other hell. The devil is clowning. Little town called Clarksdale. Did some work for Mr. Smith.
I'm James Super Chikan Johnson from Clarksdale, Mississippi. I represent Clarksdale. I'm like the ambassador. It's home. Muddy Waters is from there. He lived on the Stovall plantation. And I think I saw Muddy Waters a time or two. I was a kid at the time, but didn't know who I was looking at. But matter of fact, when I was kid and my grandpa was living, I remember seeing Johnny Hooker drove up in the yard and my grandpa hollered at him and called him Hook. He said, "What's up, Hook?" And he said, "Hey, Bro Johnson." And they got to talking and grandpa pulled out his fiddle. Mr. Hook got his guitar out and they sat on the porch and played. And I used to like to hear him play so much that I made me a dilly bow. And whenever they started playing, I would grab my stick and my wire and I'd sit there and play right along with them.
Oh, yeah. TB is killing me. Oh, yeah, baby. The TB is killing me.
The blues spread in the early 20th century by a number of means. Sheet music of blues came out in the teens. Phonograph records of blues musicians came out starting in the 1920s, but blues musicians always traveled. Sometimes it was with medicine shows, sometimes it was with vaudeville tent shows, but a lot of times they were playing simply for people in their community. And a lot of times in their community, there was a small house, a small club, that everybody came to on the weekend, and that club was called a juke joint.
I live across the street from a juke joint, mama. All night long, they play the blues.
At one time, I mean, juke joints was everywhere. And it started out with the gambling out in the woods. Then pretty soon it got to be a gathering place because everybody was having so much fun out there. And pretty soon they wasn't gambling anymore. They was playing music and dancing. But the blues was kept out in the woods and kept hidden and smothered down because it was called devil music, ugly music, and all other kind of names. Finally, when they broke out of the woods, man, they spread it like the measles or something, you know. They was all over the place, and there got to be too many of them, and it started having too much whiskey drinking and too many fights. And so then they started to say, well, we need to put the blues back out in the woods or whatever it came from because it's causing too much corruptions.
Juke joints were well known as a place where you could drink, meet women, dance, and gamble. The irony of it is, in the 21st century, that it's gambling that's helping to kill the juke joints.
That casino remind me of the Bible. The Bible said before the end of time, there'll be many plagues on earth. The casinos are a plague. Well, the casinos, well, no, us not been used to anything like that in the Delta. And it came in there, and they were like loose, and everybody went out there, and they won money and got baited in real good. And once everybody got baited in and got hooked on it, man, and I heard one guy say, man, with a game like this, a man don't need a job because I could come out here every day and win me $300 or $400. That's exactly what the casino wanted you to feel.
In many ways, the new corporate-sponsored riverboat gambling has taken the place of the juke joints. Instead of getting in your car and driving to a local juke joint, you're just as likely, or perhaps even more likely, to get in your car and drive up to Robinsonville where you can gamble and hear music and have a nice dinner at a place that's a little bit more upscale than the juke joint you're used to. And in many ways, these gambling emporiums are taking the place of the old-style Mississippi Delta juke joint.
Instead of people going to the clubs anymore, they want to go get back their money that they think they're going to get back. So the clubs that usually would charge you a small fee at the door, you know, I mean, they said, well, shoot, I could take this $5 or $10 and go to the casino with it. That's what killed a lot of clubs, too. You know, they didn't get no trade with nobody coming, so there wasn't no need in being open.
The blues is always changing its form. The older style Mississippi Delta blues you would have heard in the 19-teens and 20s is pretty much gone. But the new face of the Delta blues, which is electrified guitars played in juke joints, is still around. Even that will change, and it's unknown where that music will head. But you can always be sure that in a place like Mississippi, black Americans will be down, but they will never be out.
The blues is still well alive in Clarksdale. It's not nearly gone. The blues scene in Clarksdale is not over with unless we let it be.
I'm just a poor, broke boy down in northern Mississippi. I'm just a poor down in northern Mississippi.
Thanks for listening. I'm Kip Lornell of George Washington University for Arts Edge, a program of the Educational Department of the John F. Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts.